Imagine if you're in your work truck and people come up to you telling you that you stole it. It's theirs, it doesn't belong to you. You try to provide evidence, proof. No, 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 this is really my truck. And they don't believe you. Let's do this. Let's put up the picture of the young lady. This is Nicole Arlette Hirsch, a Harvard trained sociologist and an anti-racism expert. Well, damn, they picked the right one, didn't they? Says her family is considering legal options after her husband was detained and wrongfully accused of stealing his own truck. The husband is still reeling from the ordeal, is trying to remain private. Nicole is speaking out in hopes to prevent similar situations. Let's put up a picture of the truck. It is clearly a work truck. It is a 1995 white Ford pickup truck that he uses for his landscaping business. Now, who in the hell is going to steal somebody's truck and then do that to it, okay? In the same community. Let me give you the background. He was actually parked, okay? The truck was parked about a mile away from their home when a man and a woman approached the Ford and started looking around and touching the items on the truck's bed. The driver rolled down his window and asked if he could help them with something, Hirsch said. That's when the couple told the man about their stolen truck. And he said, well, this is my truck. Sorry, I can't help you. And they continued to touch his truck. He told them, I need you to back up off my property and stop touching it, she continued. Hirsch said the couple went back to their car. Her husband tried to show them a photo of him in the truck 4 years ago, but they ignored him and refused to put their windows down. About 10 minutes later, Hirsch said he thought they had driven away, but at least two police vehicles pulled up behind his truck. Now, so far, these individuals are the only ones that committed any semblance of a crime here. I mean, they are touching his property. They walk away. He tries to do more than he's required. He finds a picture of him and that same truck years ago, tries to present it to this couple. That wasn't enough. Cops were called, they came. At that point, when the cops came, he wanted to just go up to the police officers and just clear the issue quickly, got out of the car with his keys and his phone. But before he could explain, the husband reportedly had the yellow of a taser pointed at him, and he was ordered to put his hands behind his back. They immediately put him into handcuffs. They did not ask him questions. They did not ascertain the situation. They did not even have a credible complaint. They put him in handcuffs before even asking for his license or registration or anything like that, Hirsch said. He estimates he was handcuffed for about 15 minutes before the officers asked if the vehicle was registered or for the registration of the vehicle. Even after they realized the vehicle identification numbers did not match, they refused to let him go, she added. Now, she's talking about they did not match the stolen vehicle, okay? So they have the registration number of the stolen vehicle. They then run it against the vehicle that the man owns. They realize, okay, this is not a match. At this point, officers, you should apologize, let him go. Maybe you get a complaint to your supervisor, right? The Oakland Police Department confirmed that the incident happened around 11:30 a.m. last Tuesday. Officials said they got a call from someone who said they believed they had located their stolen truck and the vehicle on the scene matched the description. Hirsch said this is not the first time she and her husband, who are Bay Area natives, have experienced or seen racial profiling firsthand. Her husband was enraged during the incident, but kept his composure so it would not escalate. Now he is very subdued, she said, and hasn't wanted to relive it. Let's put up a picture of the chief of the Oakland Police Department. His name is Lerone Armstrong. Chief Armstrong is the guy in charge. Buck stops with him. The couple is deciding on whether to file a complaint with the department or through the community police review agency. Meanwhile, Hirsch also has been in touch with the Oakland Police Commission, which is investigating the matter. And I hope you all are in touch with a good civil rights attorney, okay? I hope that's part of the plan too. Once again, black male in a truck, people call, oh, it's stolen. Police arrive, he's done nothing illegal. He's trying to be courteous. He wants to clear things up. He gets arrested immediately. Why would the cop simply not ask a question? Sir, we got a report that this truck is stolen. I would, if I were a cop, and believe me, I don't want to be. But if I were a cop, first thing I would do is say, sir, can you please provide me with your registration and license so we can clear this up? I would say, obviously you didn't steal it because it took us a while to get here. And if you stole it, you would have left. So let me just go ahead and clear this up. You're not the guy, registration doesn't match. We apologize to the person who called in, they're dumbasses, continue with your life. That's it, that didn't happen. All right, Ms. Dahl, as an attorney at law, what do you see here?
I mean, I think it just outside of the law, clearly there's racial profiling by the couple and how the police handled the situation. It's really too bad. It's very hard to prove a negative like that. If someone's accusing you of doing something, it's very hard to prove the negative. He, in fact, had a photo, you know, which is too bad that the couple wouldn't let him see it. In terms of the actual civil lawsuit, you know, it's interesting because stolen vehicle, how the police respond to stolen vehicle allegations, they usually do show quite a bit of force because that tends to be the most a very dangerous phone call for the police. And I've seen it escalate much more than this when they get a stolen phone call. But still, as you say, the question for the lawsuit would be, what did they do? How long were they in handcuffs after they saw that the vehicle registration didn't match? Like you said, they should have immediately apologized and let him go. And if they didn't, at that point, it's basically an unlawful detainer from any moment past that. And that's what I would focus on, like if I were their attorney or an attorney in their case.
I think that's a great observation. You're saying after they exhausted their investigation, basically, it was proven clearly this truck was not stolen. Now you start the countdown. How long did it take them to release the individual who never should have been arrested in the first place or in handcuffs?